pish. I think any decent member of staff, this would be one of the priorities to put patients first, and this would be in the training. And I would hope that if care in nature, this is automatic to them.
Well, putting patients first, on the feeling of the patient, if you're at ease, you're going to be better prepared to accept the treatment.
Because they're the ones that first start off, that's how they've got a job. If they didn't have any patients, they wouldn't have any jobs. And patients need to be know that they've got the care at the end of the day, so that they can allay any fear, so the nurses can allay any fears or worries that they've got. I think they need to treat the people as a whole person, not just a disease, that's it.
Okay.
I think that can, if you listen to what a patient is saying about what they're going through, that will automatically put them first, I think, because you're paying attention to their unique situation. Even if, for example, I've got depression, everybody deals with it differently. So if you don't listen to me, you will generalize my problem according to the theoretical understanding of what depression is. But if you pay attention to what I'm saying about what I'm feeling, then you will understand how I am coping with it personally. So I think listening to people and not just jumping the gun, you know. And
well, I think that's what they go for. That is. I think that is the hospital job, that's what they get paid to do, to put patients first.
By giving everything what they want, their needs, that's what that means.
I think to speak more to the patient and how the patient is feeling, and if the patient needs anything changing, to listen to what they have to say.
Well, a lot of them don't ask you how you can call them, whether they can call them by the Christian name or whether they like to prefer to be called Mr. or Mrs. or Miss. And I think that is very important. You shouldn't go along and call them names like mine as Wendy. I would be quite offended if I hadn't heard the mask, first of all. How would I wish to be known?
Not leave you hanging, I think. If I walk in and I come to the reception, if you're in the middle of doing something, at least acknowledge me that I've approached. And if you need a minute, let me know. Don't just leave me standing there and then carry on doing what you're doing, leave the reception and that kind of thing. And I'm not sure whether you're free or not. Just let me know. If you're not free, say, have a sit down for, give me 5 minutes or 2 minutes, or have a sit down, I'll call you when I'm ready. If we start off with me feeling disrespected, I won't be able to open up, because I'll be, you've already, disrespecting kind of gives you this feeling that a person is not interested. So if I've come to you for help and you've disrespected me, it shows me you're not interested really. So I can't feel that you will help. So I'm better off just walking out and going away then.
Have a good understanding of people. I listen. You must listen to people, what you have to say, and help them.
I
being very careful how you address patients. Some people are quite happy with the first name, but some people are not. Again, I think it's respect is about smiling at people when you can and showing that empathy and concern.
Well, I think they could come to them every now and again and say, are you okay? Is there anything you need while you're waiting to be seen? Or something like that, just to make sure they are okay while they're seen to other patients.
It means being responsible for your actions. Whatever you do, you have to be able to back it up. You have to be, even when you do something, thinking it's the right thing to do, and it turns out to be the wrong thing to do, if you behave with integrity, you won't try and cover it up. You will be honest and say, yes, I did it at that particular time. Given the situation, I did it because I thought it was the best thing to do. You'll stand by what you do if you're behaving with integrity. If you know you didn't really do the best thing, then you'll try and cover it up. And that, for me, integrity is the opposite of covering up. You know, covering your back, because with integrity, it doesn't mean you're right or correct. It means that you can stand by the decision you took that particular time, because it was the best you had. It was the best option.
Well, it takes the fear factor out of if you ever need their services again, you'd be more at ease and not afraid to knock on their door again.
Again, because they wouldn't like it if they weren't treated like that. They would soon complain and get upset about it. My husband was talked over when he was in hospital. He got motor neurone disease, yeah, but he still could hear, he could still see, he couldn't communicate by orally. But somebody, one of the consultants said, oh, can you lip read? And then he suddenly realised what he'd said and said, ah, but you're not deaf. It's not knowing the people that they're caring for.
Yes, I think it's very important to be honest. To be honest and tell the truth and just be straightforward.
Why is it important hospital staff act with integrity?
Because it's people's lives that they're dealing with, and I think they should tell them and be straight and truthful with them. Because we need hospitals, we need hospital doctors, nurses, you know, we need them.
Yeah.
I think we can do some services in the community. It's freeing up the hospital for more serious cases.
Yeah, good idea.
And the more in the community, it's more preventing beds being blocked.
To make it run better, be a happier place.
To keep everybody well. Keep everybody well, I would say.
If they could be seen a little bit quicker than they are seen now, so that means they're going to be at ease for a longer time. The anxiousness is taken away. You know.
Without health, there would be no community, I suppose. So, yeah, they are very useful in the community, and I think they are actually the foundation of any community, I would think, is the hospitals. Because if people aren't feeling well and they can't access any treatment, sooner or later, other services will fall. because the people are there to work on.
It would be better because I think patients need to know more about themselves, what is wrong with them, what can they do to make it right, you know, what's wrong with them. If they don't know, they can't do anything.
I think first of all, they need some help from the patients as to what they seem to be needed to change. So rather than the nurses and doctors get together themselves, the patient should be involved themselves, because they're the ones at the end of the chain who are asking for the treatment.
I think they could, by being human. The hospital itself is an institution, but that institution is run by humans, and that humanity, they can bring that humanity to the institution if they if the rules and regulations aren't so many, you know, and the limitations and too much to do a short period of time. So I think the institutions are failing the people working within them, because the institutions themselves are treating their employees as superhuman, expecting them to do things that are actually impossible. And for that reason, then the person loses that humanity. There's no human touch with the institutions.
It'll run better. The hospital will run better.
Because then patients will get better quicker. If everything's negative, patients don't get the right feedback. That's what I was trying to think of just now. They don't get the right feedback from the nurses or the doctors, and they should. Therefore, they don't get the wherewithal to want to get better if they're just treated negatively all the time.
By doing things a little bit different, I would say, when you need an appointment, not having to wait a long time to get an appointment, and employing more nurses and doctors.